I'm Petra Kliba, and my biggest offshore experience was when I was 19. I was co-skipper of a round-the-world race.
My name is Ivica Kostelic. I'm an ex-pro ski racer. Last 4 years I've been racing on a class 40 in the Adriatic and the Mediterranean, and recently moved to the Atlantic. Offshore experience is something very special. It's not only about sailing, it's about being out at sea. Of course, living in sometimes crazy environment, battling the elements, but also enjoying special moments. I like to say an offshore sailor is a sailor that belongs to the sea. And this is something special. It's very nice to just get out there and enjoy in this little bubble, in this private sphere, so to speak. But at the same time, racing hard in all those crazy situations, big winds, strong currents, sometimes foul weather, it makes you feel glorious.
It's more than sailing, it's living, waking up on the ocean. Every sunset and sunrise is different. The inclusion of the double offshore handed in the Paris Olympic Games 2024, it's quite nice for us women sailors, as we had really less classes and possibilities where we could sail. It's a nice idea to get with the double offshore, really exciting, and I think also for the, it's going to be a monotype racing, so for the fans it's going to be also nice to follow this.
I think the next double-handed offshore racing is growing because it fits a modern way of living. It's quite simple to get a crew. I mean, you only need one more team member. It's, you know, collecting, assembling the whole crew of, I don't know, 4 or up to 10, 12 people is time-consuming. It's much easier to have a double-handed project. And I think it's also a lot of fun. For me, double-handed offshore is the nicest way of sailing, really.
It's not boring.
It's not boring.
You could talk to them.
Exactly. But on the other hand, there's not many conflicts on board, and it's very pleasant.
We met 6 months ago.
More?
8?
Or maybe, yeah, 6 months, yes.
6-8 months ago for the first time. We chose the race of what was 120 miles, something like that.
100 miles.
100.
Yeah.
To get to know each other, to see if we go well along on boat. On land it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It matters how we get along here on the boat.
But we get along well.
We get along well, so we decided we can go on. And then we chose races here in the Adriatic, which was basically the easiest way for us. You had this nice mini.
Yeah. I had a mini based here in the Adriatic, so we took an opportunity to use it. The other thing that was really bothering us in a way is that all the COVID travel restrictions, we couldn't travel abroad that much, so we stuck to the Adriatic and we raced in Italy and Croatia.
Next year, we hope that we will be able to travel more. Otherwise, we will stick to the mini. But if we can travel, where do we go?
We would like to race the European champs and a couple of more designated mixed double-handed offshore races. We're still waiting for the calendar to come out, and then we'll make a plan.
But we'll be there. Wherever we can, we will join the double offshore.